So the first question is from Assembly Member Sian Berry.
Thank you very much, and thank you for coming here, Minister. I've been looking at particularly the £23 million that was allocated by the government to local authorities and charities last week on the 25th of January. This money for community champions to give vaccine advice and boost the take-up. Now, it seems, looking at the list, it seems that some of the boroughs within London who have not received money are some of the boroughs that have some of the highest, in terms of number, populations of minority ethnic groups, and some of the most deprived boroughs. I can see Enfield, Croydon, Southwark, Newham, Barking, Dagenham, Tower Hamlets. They've not received any money from your department. So I'm just wondering if you can tell me more about the decision making that went on within your department for allocating those direct allocations of funds.
Thank you, Sian, and good morning, everyone. So the Community Champions Programme is something that we have developed working with local government, where they've put forward ways in which to identify and reach local champions. I am very happy to take away, Sian, any boroughs that feel that they need additional support, and we will look at that. Of course, as part of this programme, I've been working closely with local government. In fact, we have recruited one of local government's own, in Eleanor Kelly, who was Chief Executive of Southwark, who's joined the deployment programme as COO, reporting into Emily Lawson, who is the overall Senior Responsible Officer for the Vaccine Deployment Programme. So very happy to take away any concerns that you might have. Essentially, it's 23 million to work with local government to identify local leaders.
And sorry to interrupt, I'm very short of time. Will there be another allocation of funding that comes forward to fill these gaps?
Well, we always look at other additional resources if we need to, not just through local government, but also directly to some of these community groups who we think are doing really worthwhile work. This is an important part of the programme, as I'm sure you've seen. I've been spending a lot of time working across party, because this transcends party politics. And I pay tribute to my colleagues, both from the South Asian community in Parliament and the Black and Afro-Caribbean community, who have both really sort of risen to the challenge when I wrote to them to say, I need your help to get the message out. And I think both videos have gone viral of MPs encouraging people to take the jab when it's their turn. But we will always look at what more we can do to drive this message home.
Thank you.